I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of being clean. I don't set the world on fire.
War. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Let's see, are you a boy or a girl? It's a boy.
A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. Our beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about... That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up. You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be? You're just
James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions.
James.
Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on.
Okay?
One thing. We need a doctor, not a dead man. Fail to meet my expectations
now,
and there will be trouble.
James and his cheery charity.
Decorations,
may your future be bright.
Toys in this place will feel just like home. Don't look straight into the light, pal. You'll hurt your eyes. It's just something you get used to down here. Come on over here, son. Come on. Walk to Daddy. There you go. My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit. You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pin you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
Baba. Baba.
These experiments
don't
are...
Don't be a damn fool. We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive. Of course I miss her. I miss her so much. Each day I want to
survive.
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your mother...
Congratulations, young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well... You're ready to take on your first official vault responsibilities. So here you are, As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess. Ha! I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak, issue 14, and with no missing pages. I found this in a box of my father's old things, believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once. Well, I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What, are you two best friends now? Hey, Wally, I think Paul's gone soft on
us. Yeah, Paul.
Nice party,
buddy. Hey, get lost. Your new best friend.
What do you mean?
This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
Happy birthday.
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Such a nice, polite young man you are. Don't ever lose your gift to speaking your mind so directly. We could use more of that down here. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. You're the birthday boy. No sharing required today.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer. How about we share it? What are you, 5? Give me that sweet roll, I'm gonna pound you. Oh, yeah? We'll see about that. Should have just
Dad,
given me
I
the sweet.
I told you not to act all official.
Butch, what do you think you're doing?
You
leave him
joking,
alone.
But I'm not sure anyone else did.
Nonsense. People always enjoy my
give
little speech.
Breath.
Besides, that friend of yours could use
breath.
A reminder that life is not all fun and games.
Ugh, this is supposed to be a party, you know? Fun? You should try it sometime, Daddy.
Nice,
you might like it.
What is that?
Are you all right? Is Butch giving you a hard time again? I'm glad to hear it. Once you start letting bullies push you around, you'll never see the end of it. Come on now. I bet there's someone else out there with a present for you.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday! Not much, but I hope you like it.
3,000 A models? What piece of junk?
What's Butch's problem, anyway?
I can't believe he tried to start a fight at your own birthday party. What a jerk. You never learn, do you? You can't help shooting your mouth off, even when you know it's gonna get you a bloody nose. Uh-oh, your dad is giving me a look. I better let everybody else have a turn with the birthday boy.
I think you have to wind it up every morning.
Do you think we surprised him?
I'm sure.
So, what do you think we should call our dad? It's gotta be totally killing.
Now go on.
Hey, how about the vault dwellers?
Thanks for coming, Stanley.
Who wants to go around all day being called a vault dweller?
Everything's fine, I hope.
You really are as dumb as you look.
Nice party.
Come on, Wally. You always have good ideas.
I wasn't worried.
I got one. The Mackers. Super cool, right?
I'm glad you can make it.
Jeez, Wally. Who's the head of the gang? You or me?
I'll send him right down.
No way. Hey, happy birthday,
Nosebleed. Mrs. Palmer?
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Out with the decorations, you know.
Are you having a nice
day? Really? They're lovely. Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. Of course you're not five. You're a big 10-year-old man now, aren't you? With your very own Pip-Boy. And do you know what I did? Just for the occasion, wrote you a poem. I hope you like it. Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
You did such a splendid.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. Oh, I see. Now that you're 10, you're all business. Well then, mister, we'd better get to it. Happy birthday, by the way. Hang on one more minute. I think I hear someone coming.
Are you ready for your surprise? The overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? We sure can't, unless we want the overseer beating down our door. Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on. Good work. That's one less round roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas.
Get a picture of me in the big game.
Happy birthday, buddy. I hope you have fun with it. Hey, you don't turn 10 every day. Now go on and let me see you shoot something.
Good work. That's one less round road. Let's get...
Smile!
Boys and girls have different parts.
It's her part anyway, so I'm the overseer's daughter, so what? That like, I get any kind of special treatment. Tell me.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end.
As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your GOAT exam. Go on now. You've got a GOAT to take. Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the GOAT. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine. Take care, son. Now get out of here, and good luck.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old man before...
Well, you made it. All set for the GOAT? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through. I'm sure you will, especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers. We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck. As soon as everyone takes their seats, we can get started. Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response? Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do? Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do? Question four. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer? Question five. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another Vault resident. What do you do? Question six. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed? Question seven. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation. And a mutated hand is grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment? Question 8. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it? Question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and... Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland, and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well... there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants.
Thanks for your help, jerk. It's good to know I can count on you when I'm in trouble.
Buzz off, nosebleed.
Here you are, Mr. Bratch. I hope I did okay.
Oh, look, it's Doc's kid. Great. What do you want, nerd boy?
Very well done. Looks like it's the supervisory track for you.
Thanks. See you tomorrow.
Yo, Teach! I'm done!
Ah, Butch. Can I admit that I've been waiting for this day for a long, long time? Allow me to savor the moment. Now then, let's see. Really? Interesting. You surprised me, Butch. I didn't think you had it in you. Hairdresser. Who would have thunk it?
You're so full of it. That isn't true. I've got other things to do. I'm all done, Mr. Brotch. I guess. Wait a second. Can I have it back? I think I need to change one of my answers.
Just calm down a minute, Paul. I'm sure you have nothing to worry about. Let's see. Yep, just as I thought. You're slated for the engineering track. Congratulations, Mr. Hannon. You've passed the goat.
Oh, gee. That's not so bad. Engineering, all right.
Hey.
All finished? Wow. Wow. It says here you're going to be the Vault's marriage counselor. Almost makes me want to get married, just to be able to avail myself of your services. Yes, it's refreshing to see such, youthful enthusiasm. Good to know that the goat occasionally gets it right. You know what they say about monkeys and typewriters. Well, I'm glad things turned out so well for you. I hope your classmates find their results half as satisfying.
Can't wait to find out if I'll be going into science or home economics.
Science.
Bye. Yes?
Leave me alone, you little spaz.
Hey, what did you put for number 10?
See you tomorrow.
Get out of my nerves.
Anything is possible, even an egg.
That is
Mr. Brock
here to save you now. Is helping you get back to work.
Selfish and insupportive. Just like
you need to know.
Wake up! Come on, wake up!
I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on! You've got to wake up! You've got to get out of here! Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you! He's left the vault! I don't know how, but he's gone, and my father, he's kind of gone crazy. It's Jonas! They killed him! My father's men! They took him and... Oh my God, you have to leave now! Yeah, don't worry about me. I'm just sorry you had to find out like this. I know Jonas was your friend. But we've got to go now. My father's men will be here any minute. I'm sorry, but I think you'll have to follow your dad. You'll have to escape from the vault. Listen, maybe it isn't any of my business, but didn't your dad tell you that he was leaving? Oh, okay. Sure. But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan. Listen, there's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case. Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck! I'll meet you at the vault door if I can, but don't wait for me.
There he is. Hold it right there!
Roaches!
Get it off me!
Gotta help me! My mom's trapped in there with the rat roaches! Please, I know I've always been a jerk towards you. I know it! But you can't walk away and let her die just because I was an asshole! Please! I'm begging you! Okay, sure. You can join the Tunnel Snakes. I'll be your best friend forever. Whatever you want. Just save my mom. No. No, I'm not going back in there. I can't! Wow. Where'd you get that? Okay. Maybe I can do this. All right. I'm gonna go back in there and kill those damn roaches. Thanks.
Oh, you're lucky it was me who found you. The others won't be so forgiving. I don't know what you're up to, and I don't want to know. Just clear out of here, and I'll pretend I never saw you. Don't think I don't know it. Why do you think I'm letting you go? I guess you're trying to follow your dad. Outside. Good gravy, if I didn't know what the Overseer would do if he caught you, I'd never tell you to try for it, but it's your only shot. You take care, and I hope you find your daddy.
This is the Overseer now.
should just go back to our quarters.
It's our only chance, don't you see?
Security personnel.
He's my friend. I was worried about him. What does he have to do with any of this anyway?
Probably.
Thank you.
actually opened it. Good, you're leaving. I guess you were trying to help me, but you... You didn't have to kill him! Oh, really? And who appointed you judge, jury, and executioner? I know he wasn't perfect, but he was my father. I thought you were my friend. He was the only family I had left. I thought you, of all people, would have understood that. You'd better get out of here before I change my mind and call the guards.
Stop! Bring it! I'm not going out there. I don't care what the overseer says. I knew you. Please.
Y'all be careful with that car weapon. Have yourself a nice visit, partner.